Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Valor Legends Eternity on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Valor Legends Eternity and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5. Which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Valor Legends Eternity. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all mates, to start we have to open our main web browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL I'm highlighting in green. Now, you are able to see on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type anything, because I provided the link in the video description and the first main comment. We landed there on our own website of Usitility, where we include a in-depth information on how to download and install Valor Legends Eternity on PC. We scroll down a tad and just click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we reach the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we are going to use to play Valor Legends Eternity on PC. It is now obvious that we have several advantages of running the emulator. Now we are ready to start downloading the Valor Legends Eternity by clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. We then click on it. And the download action takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It is an executable file. The following step is to run the installer, so we have to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the computer. We said yes. I minimize the internet browser to start to see the installer much better. The installer is very simple. It is made up of two options, install and setup path. I will clarify what setup path truly does. We merely simply click on it. And we note that we display here the path in which the emulator will be placed. If we need to vary this directory we have got to click on the browse button. Therefore we choose another directory and install the emulator exactly where we wish. I prefer to set it by default. I simply click back. And I simply click install. Now, there it is. The setup commences and it's going to continue along with the download of these MB that are visible on the screen. The time you download it, it could be a little bit more or less megabytes. The download rate can be at a higher speed or slower, determined by your connection and depending on the velocity of the emulator servers. Today they're working quite fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator happens to be started immediately. As you can see, down here, we have a progress bar that will fill up then when it actually reaches the finish, the emulator will be started for the first time. In reality the emulator was already started, here for the first time. Before we continue, as you can see now, it created two icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be the only one we are considering. The moment we want to operate Valor Legends Eternity on our desktop or laptop, we twice mouse click on that icon and therefore start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's perform the next phase, that is a must, and which is to entry the Google Play Store. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As you can discover the Google Play is started. In this case we must sign in. At this moment as soon as we're there, we are required to conduct the following step which is imperative. So we simply click on Sign In. Now it shows Checking Info. It might in some cases get stuck in Checking Info, additionally it doesn't advance. If so, you could attempt to log in after a few hours and it will surely most certainly be solved. Now we're going to type our email and password. The email address has to be a Gmail email address and its associated password. For example, you may use the same exact email you use right now in your YouTube account. Thus, I will submit my information and I'll return as soon as I have done it. That's it, details typed. And here is Google welcoming us and offering us their terms of service. We should agree to them all by hitting, I agree. Next, it makes us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You could leave it selected and it'll build a backup of your data on this device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you can utilize that feature if you prefer. We simply click on accept. Google Play is launched without need to open it manually and immediately. To install the video game, we have to browse the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this icon indicated in green. Now that we are watching the desktop of that Android emulator, we see that we have now here the install application button. We then click on the button. Here we have got the Android game. Let's quickly click on right here on the install option that I am just highlighting now in green color. And it will commence the software setup. At present it will download on your laptop or computer and install the game app. It might take quite some time or it could possibly be almost immediate. It all relies on our web connection. It's by then ended installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by pressing the following button that I am showing in green, to be able to start Valor Legends Eternity for the first time. We are by then on the emulator desktop, and then we are going to click this brand new Valor Legends Eternity icon that was created. The video game is started for the very first time. Currently there we end up with it, I'm able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will discuss the sound level of this emulator. It is right here. We have the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This way we do not depend on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of the emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the greatest, we could turn on the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This is actually the very first one. We just click on this app icon that I'm mentioning in green color. And the monitor is maximized, enjoying one border at the top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. In case we wish to play the video game in full screen, we mouse click on this game icon. And consequently we would likely without a doubt be experiencing the video game in 100% screen mode. To quit the full screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we might just end up being in normal display mode. Now I am choosing to explain you the computer keyboard mapping which is definitely extremely helpful. This step we will be capable to play the game much more easily. The very first point is to press the software icon. And there you will be able to complete the required adjustments. I can keep the standard configuration, though if you want to modify this, you can achieve it without any problem. As you can see, the emulator is entirely in our own language. Occasionally it happens that your emulator is launched in the improper language, for example, in Mandarin. And consequently to place it in the appropriate language we go here to the cogwheel. And there throughout additional configurations, we click the language drop down. We can also select the language we like, German, Chinese, etc. As soon as the language is chosen, we should save, the emulator would restart, and also the game application, next time we run it, will as well be in the selected language. At this moment, there's another point that we will need to take into account, and this is that we will receive an email indicating that a completely new device has been linked to this Google account. It will question us if we are the people who have associated with that electronic device. Yup, we shouldn't be troubled, as the emulator is emulating an Android electronic device. And to find which tablet or smartphone is being emulated, we arrive right here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. And we go here to the model selection. And right here we discover that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for my training. I believe you appreciated it, particularly that everyone found it informative. If so, offer it a pleasant like, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your remarks, issues or ideas, put them in the comment box down below. You could also comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams every once in a while, you have it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Click on any of those video tutorials that are appearing on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the future videos. Bye.